Hey, Charles Hoffman here from iZotope, and I can't wait to walk you through the newest version of iZotope's distortion plugin, Trash. If you've been an iZotope user for a while, you might be familiar with a distortion plugin called Trash 2. Over the years, it's developed a following for its ability to creatively mangle, crush, and obliterate sounds. There's been so much demand for a new version of this plugin, and today, we're excited to introduce a reimagined version of Trash. Trash 2 was a deep plugin with many layers to it, but we discovered that most producers wanted fast and inspiring results, so they'd go straight for the presets. We've completely redesigned Trash from the ground up with a modern producer's workflow in mind. This new version of Trash is focused on creativity and productivity. There's a massive library of distortion presets and Convolve presets. Using the XY pads, you can blend between these presets, so the processing options are endless. You can apply separate processing to three different bands. There's built-in envelope modulation, a global filter, auto gain, and a limiter. There's also three dice roll buttons that randomize Trash's settings, providing you with unlimited inspiration. You'll notice that unlike in Trash 2, almost every setting is available right in front of you. You don't need to go menu diving to find features. Head to iZotope.com using the link below to download Trash. You can get started with some of the plugin's features for free, or upgrade to the paid version to access Trash's full range of capabilities. There's also a version of Trash available to iPad users that make music with the mobile version of Logic. If you're on an iPad, you can download Trash directly from the App Store. I'll play some before and after audio examples to give you a sense of how Trash sounds. Since this is more of a sound design plugin than a mixing plugin, I'll randomize the wet settings because randomization is a huge part of the workflow in Trash. Afterward, we'll walk through all of Trash's features in depth. The majority of Trash's sound comes from the Trash and Convolve modules. The Trash module allows you to apply a blend of different distortion algorithms to your sound. In each corner of the XY interface, there's a drop-down menu that contains 69 distortion wave shapes. They're sorted into various categories, which makes finding the right type of distortion for your sound simple. You can manually load a different algorithm into each corner, but what I like to do is click the dice roll button to randomize the algorithms. From there, you can move this node to blend together distortion wave shapes. If you click on this fader icon, you'll see that some algorithms have a style parameter that becomes active. Generally, turning up an algorithm's style knob is going to deliver a grittier and more destructive sound. This big drive knob adjusts the Trash module's input gain. As you turn it up, you'll hear progressively more distortion and saturation applied. The tilt knob controls a filter that either boosts your low end or top end, driving it harder into the Trash module. This slider controls the center frequency of the tilt filter. In this case, frequency content below 1500 Hz will get boosted when you turn the tilt knob to the left. And frequencies above 1500 Hz will get boosted when you turn the tilt knob to the right. You also have a mix knob that controls the blend between the dry signal entering the trash module and the wet distorted signal. This allows you to dial back the intensity of the effect and apply parallel processing just within the trash module. The Convolve module introduces an impulse response, or IR, to your sound. An impulse response is a recording of a brief sound played in a particular space. An impulse could be the sound of your hands clapping in a room, a balloon popping in a parking garage, or really any abrupt sound. The space that the impulse is created in will affect the sound you hear. For example, if you create the same impulse outdoors versus inside an enclosed space, the echoes and reflections of both spaces will sound much different. These characteristics are the response, or the way the environment is contributing to the sound that you hear. When you record an impulse response and import it into Trash's Convolve module, the sound running through Trash will appear like it's playing in the same space as the impulse that you recorded. You're going to get some of the character of the original sound coming through as well. You can load any audio file from your computer and Trash will grab the first second of audio. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. Foley recordings captured on your phone work great and can be used as impulse responses. If you want to work quickly and don't have time to record all your own impulse responses, no problem. There's over 300 pre-recorded IRs to choose from, including amps, vowels, textures, and many other categories. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. Similar to the Trash module, you can use the XY pad, in this case, to blend together different impulse responses. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. There's another dice button to randomize all the IRs. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. If you want to hear more of the spatial effect introduced by the IR, you can turn up the mix knob. This will control the blend between the dry signal and convolved signal. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. The width knob acts like a mid-side balance control. In the center position, it doesn't affect your sound. To the left, the sides will be reduced in level, drawing attention to the mids. To the right, the mids are reduced, pulling your attention to the sides. Something to keep in mind is that this knob only has an effect if you're processing a stereo signal. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. Let's say you have a mono signal that you want to make wider. Well, you can do this using the stereoize knob. It applies a time delay to the left and right channels, which helps spread the convolved sound across the stereo field. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. By default, your signal runs through the trash module and then the convolve module, but you can reverse the order of processing. In some cases, doing this can have quite a significant effect on the sound. Depending on the sound you're going for, you may only want to apply processing to a certain frequency range. In the multiband display, which contains three bands, you can adjust the crossover frequency of the lows and mids and highs. This feature allows you to maintain the soft and round low end of an 808 while distorting the top end, or dial back the brightness of the processing applied. Each band uses unique trash and convolve settings, so there's a lot of room to be creative here. You can also solo each band and adjust its gain. Trash's envelope feature lets you apply modulation to the trash drive module and XY pad. You can also use it to modulate the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter, which we'll get into in a moment. This envelope tracks the level of your input signal and applies modulation accordingly. If I apply positive modulation to the drive knob, more drive will be applied to the signal when there are peaks in the waveform. This parameter controls the maximum amount of modulation that can be applied, whereas the modulation slider controls how much modulation is applied within that range. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. There are attack and release parameters. The attack slider increases the amount of time it takes for the envelope to respond to the incoming signal. As you increase the attack time, the envelope will become less responsive to the input signal, so brief peaks in the waveform won't cause as much modulation. This can help smooth out the sound if you notice that transients are making the distortion applied sound too harsh. You can use the release slider to increase the amount of time it takes for modulation to back off a parameter. If you're affecting the drive knob and the distortion sounds choppy and stuttery, turning up the release will fix that issue and result in distortion that remains applied longer and decays smoothly. Modulating the XY pad to adjust the blend between different distortion algorithms is a great way to add organic variation to your sound. You can treat low-level parts of your input signal with light distortion and high-level parts with heavy distortion. The teal meter in the background of the XY pad visualizes the way drive affects the wave shaping as it modulates and how different wave shapes look when modulating between each other. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. It's also possible to invert the processing for a completely different effect. The meter above the drive knob shows you whether positive or negative modulation is occurring. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. Don't really care for more, yeah. Don't really care for more, yeah. Can't get you out of my head, no. Please just leave me alone. Demons are eating my skin, yeah. Stuck in the past, can't win, yeah. Voice is taking over, so maybe it's over. The filter section provides you with a low-pass filter that filters your signal post-multiband processing, affecting the entire sound. The frequency slider controls the cutoff of the filter, rejecting frequency content above the value you've selected. The scream control applies a resonance boost at the filter's cutoff frequency. On its own, this can add some texture to your sound, but it really shines when you apply modulation. The teal meter displays the movement of the cutoff filter when modulation is applied. At moderate values, modulation can lead to laser beam effects. At higher values, the filter goes into self-oscillation. When you run an audio signal through it, harmonic content remains applied to the signal. If you reduce the level of each band, you'll end up with mostly this harmonic sound. The heat slider adjusts the input gain. You can use it to drive your signal to apply additional saturation and distortion. There are manual input and output gain sliders, in addition to an auto gain feature. When you turn this feature on, Trash adjusts the output gain to match the loudness of the input gain as closely as possible. This eliminates loudness bias, which is our tendency to perceive louder sounds as better. Using auto gain can help you make more well-informed sound design choices. There's also a built-in limiter to prevent peaks from clipping. At the top of the interface, there's a presets menu that contains over 300 presets broken down by use case. You can create your own presets, delete presets, update presets, and rename them. Your presets will appear in the user presets folder. I've been using this bypass switch throughout the video to toggle the plugin's processing on and off. You also have a global mix slider that controls the blend between the unprocessed signal entering trash and the processed version of the sound. Head to iZotope.com using the link below to download Trash. Again, you can get started with some of Trash's features for free, or upgrade to the paid version to access everything Trash has to offer. Don't forget, you can also download Trash on iPad through the App Store if you work with Logic. Make sure to subscribe to the iZotope YouTube channel for more walkthroughs like this, and give this video a like if it helped you out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.